Well, our next guest is certainly not to be messed with. You better be on your best behaviour, Joe. I did give you a bit of a whipping yesterday, but...
I've already broken my arm,
Wait till you see Emma.
When it comes to packing a punch, few come better equipped than Australia's first female wrestling star. Known as Emma, she's a favourite on America's WWE circuit, attracting crowds of up to 70,000 thanks to her killer moves. Her ringside bubble dance also goes down a storm, and she's hoping to boogie her way into Australian hearts during her debut homecoming tour.
WWE Diva, please welcome Australia's own Emma! Look at her go! She is beautiful! I can't spell it, but she is beautiful! It's our own Diva Emma!
Very nervous men here.
Yeah.
Or excited men.
Well,
yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. All
right. Hey, welcome to the show. You've been a wrestler all your life. We've actually got some gorgeous pictures of you as a little girl.
Oh, really?
Yes, in your wrestle attire.
Yeah.
Oh. She's cute, but she can body slam you like
she
no one else.
She probably still beat me up.
Yeah.
What's deceiving, isn't it?
What was it that attracted you to the sport? Did you have brothers that you used to beat up? Or?
I have three older brothers, actually, but my older brother, Jake, got me into wrestling when I was about 8 years old, and I kind of fell in love with it more than he did and never snapped out of it.
Did you do the whole thing of, you know, chucking a few mattresses on the lawn and jumping off the roof?
Well, basically what I did is I found a local show and I insisted for months and months and months my mum take me there to learn how to wrestle until I got my way.
There's this massive underground thing of wrestling in Australia, isn't it? A lot of people don't know about it.
I wrestled around Australia for years until I was 19, and then I moved over to Canada to get some professional training there.
Wow. Now, some people say that wrestling of the type you do is all staged.
Oh, God. You know nothing.
These are the catching questions Australia wants to know. How much acting is involved?
Well, it's sports entertainment. So we have a bunch of trained professionals. They're athletes. So what we do, it takes years and years of learning how to perfect these moves. And what we do, you know, you can't fake it. Like, get in there and you see some of the things, you need to know how to do it, and we get injuries just like any other sport, you know.
You do get battered and bruised and stuff, like, when it's kind of stowed or choreographed a bit, you're still getting whacked, you're still hitting the canvas.
Yeah, exactly.
There's no rehearsal that goes on between you and the opponent?
There is, like, you have conversations, but a lot of us have wrestled each other for years, so we know so much about each other, and we can kind of just get in there and get let the feel of it happen, and, you know, there's always an end result. It's just like a soap opera, basically. You know, so you know what's going to happen. There's a storyline, there's characters, but it's obviously a sport too, and it's all mixed in together.
And do you get... Oh, sorry,
I was just going to ask you... quite obsessed. That's so my... how do you get into your... Like, who decides on your persona, your character? Right. Like, I noticed when you came out... You punch bubbles, which I laughed because the bubbles here were tiny.
I have tiny bubbles, and when I come out on Raw, they have giant bubbles that have soap in.
That's what I was looking at.
That one didn't even break when you kicked it.
There's smoke inside them, so I get pretty distracted. Sometimes I forget what I'm supposed to be doing.
Yeah. Is that your idea, or did they come up with that? Or what did they say?
It was a bunch of us, because we have a school where we basically learn everything in the ring and everything in front of the camera, character work, and we put it all together, and then basically I got my music, then I kind of adapted my dance off of the music, then came the bubbles, and it all just was a process.
I've got to say, it kind of looked like you dropped a couple of disco biscuits before you came out on stage.
Having fun.
That's awesome.
And do you get told, all right, you know, the fans have spoken, you're a good guy. And then, you know, if something goes wrong, I'm sorry, you've turned evil, you're going to have to throw this next
sometimes
one.
Sometimes the fans are the ones that can determine that. Sometimes, like, they might want you to be the good guy, but you come out and maybe the fans don't like you, so they set the tone.
What's not to like, you know? You're fantastic.
I am one of the good guys, so...
Is this a lucrative sport?
You can't hate bubbles.
Is wrestling lucrative?
Well, that's what
you make a lot of money?
It's not about the money for me, but we trained athletes, professionals. It's my full-time job. Mm. Yeah, so that's what I do for a living.
Can you wrestle Joe?
Yeah.
Well, do you need Joe? Just show
him. I'm not Joe, by the way.
Sorry, I was pointing
this direction. Body slam. We want a body slam.
Body slam. Does our OH&S insurance cover this?
Oh, exactly.
A cockroach could probably take you out.
You can see Emma.
I'm ready.
I can't. We can't have Joe off the show.
You can see more of Emma when she takes on the best wrestlers in the world here in Australia. WWE Live takes place in Melbourne, Brisbane and Sydney from August 7 till 9. Tickets are available through Ticket Tech. You just got kissed by an angel.